how satisfying is it for you to see intelligent drama like Parade's End being celebrated as much as it is here today?
I'm thrilled, really, really happy, because it was a challenge, I think, for even the most intelligent writer in the shape of Tom Stoppard to make this a linear story out of one of our most famous modernist novels. And I think to not insult an audience's intelligence and to give them something that's got an immense amount of depth and is incredibly well crafted and has subtext in amongst beautiful spoken word, I think is fantastic. So no, I'm thrilled. I'm very, very happy. I think it shows that our cultural barometer is good. It's healthy.
Such a powerful moment in human history. Why do you think stories from that period continue to have such a resonance with modern audiences?
I think you just said it, because it is such a powerful moment in human history, and it's still within recent times, even if it's outside of the living memory, sadly, now of many who survived it. But that level of destruction and trying to understand why a society would go into that sort of free fall is, I think, going to obsess us hopefully for a long time until we learn the lessons. And maybe then, slowly, I mean, although a lot of it's to do with human nature, we'll look at the sort of the venal appetites of the Edwardian era, the mess of diplomacy, the false promises, the shattered idealism of a society that cared for many but was only actually really feeding the top layer, sending millions of men to their early graves. Maybe, you know, there are still lessons sadly to be learned from that in our current times, whether it's the financial comparison or the fact that we've been fighting three wars in the last few years. So it'll have relevance as long as money markets behave the way they behave and we go to war for the reasons we've been going to war.
Why was it so special? Well, it was a combination of things. It was a truly remarkable, unusual script, and it had a sort of preposterously dreamlike ensemble of actors, including, you know, most of the good and the great from British theatre and TV and film, and, you know, Benedict Cumberbatch is a dream to work with, and I've known him for ages. So it was a fun thing for friends to do, as well as apart from everything else.
What makes Benedict such a dream to work with?
Benedict is a very present actor, and he's very, very smart, and he's very clued in. He's there for you, and he's supportive, and he's also very well good tempered and funny, which frankly counts for a lot.
Well, I think there was a very wonderful adaptation by Tom of a very, very complex group of novels. So that, without that, we couldn't have proceeded at all with any confidence. And then Susanna, our director, who just remained incredibly calm with all the difficulties of shooting something like that. Locations and period and stuff like that, and of course the locations and the period was wonderful. But I think what's interesting about it is that it gives a more complex view of that period, either side of the First World War, and perhaps that was appreciated by the audience, the viewers.
Clearly is such complex and ambitious drama. I mean, what were the biggest challenges from a production point of view and from an acting point of view?
Well, I think from a production point of view, doing some of the First World War, you know, I mean, and that was challenging from an acting point of view, because, I mean, both my grandfathers fought in the First World War, and we all kind of know it's in our kind of collective memory that it was terrible. But even just being out there on those endless, endless fields in Flanders, where it was freezing cold, you got the tiniest little taste of what it might have been like for them in obviously much, much, much worse conditions. Well, they're very fine actors, and they're very relaxed human beings who just get on with their work. It was very impressive to see Benedict, who was in, you know, he was filming most days, really, to take on something so enormous and to do it with such grace, really.
Thank you. We've got to let you go, but final question. Do you have a message to your devoted fans out there? Because there's a lot of people out there who love your work very much.
Well, thank you very much. And that's sort of what it's about for me, is to do the work and not talk about too many other things that will get me into trouble. So I'd love to say thank you to all of you, because that's a harmless truth. Thank you.